Hi, I'm Jeff Strang, Product Line Director for Renesas Electronics Industrial Power Product Family. I'm here today with DK Singh, our Product Marketing Manager, so that we can talk about our new family of high voltage buck boost controllers. DK?
Thanks, Jeff. Hi, I'm DK Singh, Product Marketing Manager for Industrial Power Products at Renesas Electronics. Today we are introducing true bidirectional high voltage buck boost controllers. These products use a unique architecture that enables circuit designer to implement a true bidirectional circuit by sensing true peak inductor current in both sides and in both directions. These controllers have four independent control loops to manage and control voltages and currents at both ends. It ensures high operational reliability by providing instant current limit in a fast transient condition at both input and output ends. The ability to limit negative peak current accurately allows users to exploit the bidirectional operation and optimize overall battery backup system for battery utilization and the battery health. CC operation down to a very low voltage avoids any runaway condition in the event of overload or short circuit. The new high voltage buck boost controllers from Renesas Electronics are highly integrated and provide a robust solution for battery backup designs. Some of the other key features are multi-layer overcurrent protection and multiple functions such as light load efficiency mode, external bias, and low quiescent current to improve the battery runtime. In summary, a true bidirectional buck boost controller for DC power applications provides utmost efficiency and improves overall system reliability. Jeff, do you have any question?
Thanks, DK. These are very impressive new products, a lot of capabilities in them. Let's start with one that comes to mind immediately. Why do we call these true bidirectional buck boost controllers?
It's a very good question. Actually, these controllers have a unique architecture that allows user to sense true peak current at both ends and in both directions. And having true peak current information allows users to avoid extra circuitry required to get those information.
So when we talk about measuring the current, I expect that energy management is a big deal, important application for these controllers. What type of energy storage devices do we support?
This is designed for a wide variety of energy storage devices, but we have really tested on a few types in our lab, such as lithium ion batteries, lead acid batteries, and even with supercapacitors. Okay. The point is these devices are allowed to change all the settings, even the live current and voltage settings on the fly. So all the parameters can be adjusted on the fly according to the battery type and battery chemistry.
All right. So whether we're powering and charging a supercapacitor or a lead acid battery or a lithium ion battery, I expect that efficiency is very important. Can you talk about what we've done to optimize efficiency in these sorts of battery powered and supercapacitor powered applications?
So we have three stages of efficiency improvement modes. For heavy load, we go into CCM mode. For medium loads, we go into DCM mode. And at very light load, we move into burst mode, where it is allowed to skip cycles. At the same time, we also have external bias feature that allows user to use any power rail available on the board, such as 5 volt, 12 volt, or even 24 volt. It supports up to 36 volt. So user can use any ready-made available rails on the board and save energy from the main rail. We also have a very low quiescent current considering this is a 60 volt device.
Okay. So what are some other major features of these controllers that you'd like to highlight?
We have tried to make this device as universal as possible. So we have a long list of features, but I would like to stress on a couple of them, which is more universally talked about, such as dithering feature to get control over EMI issues. We also have frequency synchronization, again to play with the EMI or any frequency noise issue that user might have. Okay, so it can be synchronized to any switching frequency, either with the system or any other device. Additionally, this device is also capable of running in parallel. That means if one controller can deliver up to 100 watt, and if you need more power, you can parallel 2, 3, 4 and get more power. And all those parallel operations are interleaved. Okay, that again saves user on input capacitor side.
Very impressive. So not only do we have two different ways to control EMI, both with dithering and with clock synchronization to a master clock, but you can also parallel these modules if you need more power than you can get from a single one.
That's correct.
Thanks, DK. That was very interesting. To learn more about Renesas Electronics' new high-voltage buck boost controller family for battery backup applications, and to get information about our evaluation boards and design tools, visit renesas.com.